Miller.
I'm going to jail.
Thank you.
A relationship between two people that doesn't have them related. So like doctor, patient, lawyer, client, and co-workers? What kind of co-workers? Where do they work? They're firefighters? Great. So, firefighters, let's do this. I don't know how this is going to work. I'll leave it up to you guys. Here's how this is going to work. You guys are the firefighters. You guys are the fire. Oh, yeah. Yeah, take that. I'm quite the dark. So, here we go. You guys are going to be the firefighters, and you're going to be the fire. All right? Here we go. We're going to start with the firefighters.
Don't you do that! TV talk show host telling us this was all prank.
The President of the United States.
The ex-girlfriend of Leo.
Okay, so is it?
Her mom.
A sack of hats. An MTV talk show host telling us this was all a prank.
The President of the United States.
Some enchanted USA.
So, let's review. Here we have
Rice.
Rotate right. Here we have
Renaissance
Fair. Rotate right. Here we have
Scientist.
You guys feel free to say it. You guys feel free to say it. Scientist. Rotate right. And this is where we started, yes?
No.
Don't spin it to the wind.
That's right. All right, great. We're going to start right here. I will say rotate left or rotate right. Just listen to that part. And then, of course, our monkey little can insert himself at any point that he likes. Players, here we go.
Oh,
two.
Oh, no.
You won!
there and welcome back to 6 o'clock news. My name is Ted, the Tedster. Now, welcome all to my show. It's a pleasure having you. Tonight we're discussing that Hawaii is in fact a myth. Hawaii, go figure. Oh, this just then, I'm getting something. Oh my God. Dallas has broken his leg because he tried to skateboard. Okay, we're going right now to the scene of the crime with Judy. Judy, are you there?
I'm right here, thank you, Ted.
Okay, Judy, what's going on? Try to fill us in here. I've lost words.
Well, Tedster, it appears that Dallas was moving down the street at approximately 3 miles per hour on his skateboard.
Folks at home, that's 3 miles an hour.
When his skateboard seemed to run on a collision course with a small, furry animal. Probably a squirrel, maybe a cat. We don't know yet. We're looking into that.
Okay, Judy, that is... Okay, I'm going to have to cut you off right now because we're actually going to a skateboard factory where it seems workers have gone on strike because the squirrel incident with the skateboard. Let's go there right now. We've got a helicopter view of the crime. United Nations, yes, but they're having a quick emergency meeting about Dallas and his skateboard. Please, go.
Okay, I'm fully aware that this is a big problem.
Mr. Kofi Annan, what should we do?
I have no idea. Skateboard and animal rights activists for the squirrel that was run over are striking all over. They're rioting, they're tearing places down.
I'm going to have to cut that meeting because we actually do have footage of said riot. Here it is right now. We're cutting into it now. A viewer discretion. He's advised.
Dallas!
The skateboard broken!
That makes for some good news, I must admit, Arthur. Now, we are going to Dallas himself. Yes, our very own Smith has an interview with Dallas himself right now. Smith, are you out there? Smith?
I don't hear you.
Okay, we are saying we have a rare interview with Dallas. Is Dallas there?
Dallas is right here. He looks like he's in distress right now.
Hey, Ted, sir, I'm right here.
Dallas, how are you feeling after this horrible, horrible event?
It really
hurts. Will you ever be the same? Will you ever attend a ComedySportz match again?
All my eccentricity is gone. It was destroyed on that dark, dead squirrel.
And thank you for that, Smith. Now on to the weather. With Ted. My brother, Ted. Well, it seems we have a cold front moving in. Ted, too, please explain.
Hi, it appears to be hailing cars. It is No, the riots are causing global warming to go nuts. If Bill Nye was alive right now, yeah, that's right, he died in Hailstorm.
Who's the silver guy?
That's his name, Silver Guy.
Great. I believe you. I'm not really a silver guy. Sorry. Apologies.
I'm Katie, and I'm a cheerleader.
Woo! Thank you, Katie. Thank you. You can stop. And we have?
Yeah, I'm Tammy, and I'm in music.
Just music in general? Great. Cool. And we have?
I'm a Fifi LaFrance. I'm a poodle groomer.
So you're Fifi
LaFrance? Yes, sir.
And you're a poodle groomer.
Let's go ahead.
I'm not scared of that at all. What do we got?
I'm Billy. I worked at Hurricane Aircraft Repair. You crash and we put them back together.
Is that the motto of the company?
Yeah.
That's a very, bold motto.
Well, if you survive, you usually don't care.
Okay. All right, awesome. Well, Ted, do what? Because of that awesome response, I'm going to let you pick our very first category. What's it going to be?
Cats.
Cats.
Yeah.
Great. So who here in the audience has a question about cats? An actual question that you want to have about cats. Let's go with you.
What do you do with the sauce traction?
Okay, so how do you stop a cat from scratching you?
Let's start on this end.
All right, now you take those comic books that I've got here and number 53, and you just like put it here, and you put the chest right on top of it. It'll stop.
Great.
I have two answers. They really don't like pom-poms in their faces, and they also like to toss up in the air.
Awesome, thank you. Do we have?
I just like put on your 78 and we'll just watch it scroll.
Great.
Oh, you use your poodle. You put a poodle in the front of the kitty and the kitty says,
So you put a dog in between the two of you, so you say, great. And finally?
I take him on a test ride over the ocean.
Yeah. Do you all have a big step for it? Yeah, that's it. Can we pick our next category?
Dogs?
Dogs. Hey, sensing a pattern. Sensing a pattern. Let's go over here. Yes, dogs. Why do dogs grow mustaches? Go for it.
You have a really weird dog.
Yeah.
This is why people like me exist for shading those mustaches.
If anyone would know that answer, I thought it would be you. Yes, take it away.
They eat cats.
They eat cats so they grow mustaches? All right, cool.
I actually didn't know that they grew mustaches because I'm at the top of the pyramid.
No, okay.
Hormones.
Question about Marvel Comics. Let's go with you, sir, with the hat.
Why does Captain America throw his shield?
What? Great question. Why does Captain America throw his shield? We start on this end.
Me?
Yeah, it's you.
Captain America, I can! Come on, America!
America! Great, yes?
Because throwing stuff takes energy.
Okay, yes?
Because a squirrel on the skateboard is so impactful.
Awesome.
Because it spins like a propeller.
Yeah, alright. Give me another category.
Fish.
This is the last time you give a category. Alright, fish, yes. That has a tendency to swim upside down. Should she be worried?
No, as long as you can like flip it over again. Then they're good to go.
No, it's probably doing a trick.
It's good enough for roadie school.
It's a good enough what? Roadie, okay.
Oh, damn, roadie!
No, I got it!
It's okay, you can change the value upside down.
All I understood was upside down.
Stop putting vodka in the fish tank.
This could be it. I'm gonna hate myself tomorrow, but
cars.
Yep. Guys, I need a question about cars. Take it away, little dude. Yeah. In 16, we're running that now. But yes, that's a great question, thank you. One of our younger cast members wants to know, why do you have to be 16 to get a driver's license? Start over here.
Well, when you go to the comic book convention, they give you a raffle ticket, you put it in, when you rent a Batmobile, you have to be 16 to drive it, duh!
Great!
No, you have to look cute behind the wheel, you have to wait a little bit.
Great.
So you learn to drive before you start smoking.
So, Mr. Fitness has a few bucks, so you can come, you can drive your car.
had that by 16. But okay. And finally?
You have to be 16?
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's all right. All right, over to you. Take a step forward. Give us a category.
Diamonds.
Diamonds! I need a question about diamonds. Let's go over here. Why are diamonds so expensive? Let's start it off right here in the center.
Because otherwise girls don't want them.
Great.
Because all the baseball players are so expensive, it costs a lot of money for the baseball diamond.
Category!
Potatoes.
I like how not permitted you were to that. A question about potatoes. Take it away. How do you properly eat a potato? Yes, great question. How do you properly eat a potato?
One bite at a time.
You go to a comic book convention and find Princess Leia and they say, hey, can you cut the potato for me so I can eat it? So fine.
With an F-O-R-K.
French fries.
All right, take another step forward. Here we go, give me another question.
Elbows.
Elbows, what's about elbows? Give me a question about elbows, way in the back. Yeah, you're right there. Can anyone touch their ear with their own elbow?
No!
Thank you, step forward. The team with the fewest rotations will win 5 points for their team and will be the most unfunny team tonight. Alright, so here we go. Let's get a. What is a situation that would get a group of people together that's semi-serious, that's not a furious? Oh, everyone got sad about that. Why would I do that? Yes, right there. Yeah.
A cult.
Great. Hey, so this is a cult meeting. How bi-weekly, weekly, it's up to you. So here we go, we're gonna start. Players, are you ready?
Yes!
Oh, and please keep track of the whistle blows. This voice would be so kind.
Hello.
Hello.
Do you have the tattoo?
Got the tattoo last week.
Then you can come in to the meeting.
That are we meeting about?
Well, if you enter.
I don't even care, I just want to be here.
Welcome, Rookie Blue. It looks like right in. There you go.
I don't care. I'm so proud to be here.
Welcome to the Sanctuarium.
Rotate Grant.
Welcome to the Sanctuarium. How can I feel your needs?
You belong here. Excellent. You have my help.
Yes. You are now the new leader of the club. Congratulations.
As my first proclamation, I all men in the world to run away.
Family time, all the way from
Hawaii.
roasted pig right there. We're gonna eat that roasted pig. What is it? They do the shaka, bro. I'm so all over that roasted pig right there.
You know, I've heard of these,
but I...
these murderer mimes that they just come up all sidelines and just... just come in.
Away!
Wow, look at that!
Oh,
native!
That is so native!
I'm a fighter.
No.
Can't keep it going. You don't mind if we can...
Mr. Bryson to you.
Shh. I think
and he hasn't drank his coffee yet. He hasn't had his margarita yet. That time that maybe we should tie the knot. Do you think maybe you might?
How could you pick on me?
could have been more beautiful with my eyes.
Maybe
everybody.
Oh, a vision over here!
Hey! Hey, I'm spraying water on my fire!
Oh, shit! English New Yorkese!
Australian, everybody!
Hey!
Oh, hey, let's start a fire. We put another shrimp on the bar, you mind, don't you?
Oh, Arnold! Schwarzenegger.
That's crazy, man! Why are you doing this? We are at the Chicago Zoo looking at the animals and the fish and the fishermen and stuff.
This is the best way to fish. Go to the zoo, you fish. Look at the koalas.
But you drive the Hummer and then you go see fishing.
Take the Hummer, you drive over the koala, you get the fish.
Hold on. I'll be back.
Back and back. All right. Jamaican.
Oh, man.
Good to see you, man.
Good to see you, man.
I love fishing with this guy.
The island is nice here.
I love the fishing with this guy. Oh, what happened? Samuel L. Jackson.
You are bad.
So you tell me, what is your favorite thing to do on your free time? That's our cue.
On my free time, I like to go out in a big field. You know, it's a big field with my net and just...
Ah, that's fantastic.
Well, Wanda, first I'd like to apologize for crappy and your husband. And second of all, I'd like to answer a question. What I like to do in my free time is, well, defend the people that I represent.
I see.
Lord, let me think. Lord, I like adventure. I like smoking like pipe in front of a nice fire. Yep.
That's just great. All right.
I like looking in the mirror, because I like God. I also like to play with my daughter. She's almost as good as me.
All right, now, my next question. If, say, we got married, and in 10 years, where do you think you would see us together? Let's start at the end of the line.
Well, see, I'd have a wife, so I don't know how much she'd like that. But we could maybe go in another direction. And, you know, whatever we can do to make us stronger.
Oh, some nice little hole in the wall. Settle down, find a home.
That was fantastic.
Well, and in 10 years, of course, we'll come. Besoli would probably be back in Hawaii.
That's what they say.
Well, I want you to know that opposed to everyone else here, I am ready for marriage. So, I think that in 10 years, we would be, you know, Bob and Steve, as we would be, just living in my house.
Say no more. Sounds great. Right now, I have a question. This one is very close to my heart before. Now,
first, I love to say that you and all people in this world are all very close to mine.
Now, do not interrupt. This next question that's very close to my heart, just like me, to is if I were a princess, as I know I am, and I was locked up in a big tall castle, what would you do to save me?
Well, I think that I would stick myself to the wall. You know, I'm very porous. I could get on the wall and then get up there, and I mean, I don't get back down, but boy, would we have a good time together.
Well,
now please, let's move on to them.
See, I wouldn't let you get locked up because I like big families, and I also made you a song, and it goes like this. I think you're hot, and I like that. I can buy you a car or a nice hat.
Oh. I do like this hat. Right, that's number three.
Fro, don't go there. I know a lot about being locked in towers. Isengard, do not get that princess.
Pick who you're taking out on a dream date. So first of all, tell me who you're not going to pick.
Well, I know that I am not going to be going on my dream date with Obama.
That's right. Go on.
I also know that I will not be taking Kanye West. I got to hear it. Sadly, regrettably, I have to say that I won't be going with SpongeBob.
Means. Lastly, I know exactly who you are and why I picked you, because you are Frodo Baggins.
You're in the right world.
You are Gandalf.
Alright, here we go.
Whoa.
This lipstick.
I'm singing in the rain.
Skater vibe, bro.
Need to put on my bulletproof vest before I go and protect this city.
Yeah. and the new Miss America.
Alright, get on, get up,
Coachella bow.
Welcome to Hawaii.
No, I gotta get over this huge gorge to the Temple of Doom.
This dude glides, just got so big.
Ah, the first day of peach season.
In the shower! Soap.
Ah, man, my skateboard hit a squirrel.
Well, AP season begins. I'm ready to die in AP couches.
Mr. Hall.
Oh.
specifically requested to throw this one at Mr. K. Not too accurate. Then we've got everyone's favorite school nurse, Mrs. Antista. This one is Mrs. Brown's, so
auditions for the team are next week and the week after, the 5th and the 12th.